This next comic, oh shit! You seen him at the David Letterman show, the Late Show. You see him at the Late Show. Keep it going for Will Ables. Will Ables.
Hey guys, you're looking healthy. You're welcome. Let's get that a day. Zero, that's your plant. Don't you plant that. And yeah, just to reiterate, at the Late Show, not on the Late Show. Big difference. I just tear tickets at the front for like Swedish tourists that love David Letterman. I just ended there. It was basically a postgraduate internship. It was a year long, and it was part time. And apparently Dave's not making enough money to share it with me, so I had to get a second job. So I decided to work at a gay sports bar. Yeah, that's a thing. I was raised on a farm in Maryland. And I told my dad. My dad was like, there weren't any other bars. I was like, no, Dad, this bar was for me. It was mine. And he was like, well, I just don't get it. Like, is everyone just really happy to be watching sports? And I was like, yeah, Dad, they're so happy that everyone starts making out with each other. But it was fun. My friends were always like, dude, are you gonna hit on my dudes? I was like, guys, everything about me says bottom bitch. I'm getting hit on. It's a fact. But I did all right. I played it up a little bit. Like, I worked for tips, so, you know, I had to. And I was talking to this guy. And, you know, things were going well. And, after a little while, he's like, you know, man, I've had a lovely time talking to you. Could I have your number? I'd love to take you out to dinner sometime. And I was like, no, I'm sorry, man, I'm straight. But now I'm looking at this guy. And this is, like, the best-looking guy I've ever seen. And so now I'm like, whoa, you think that I'm worthy of this? You put in at least 30 hours a week in the gym. And he wants to buy me dinner. Like, I deserve a good man, too. I gave him my number. It's the first time I ate in 3 days. We got oysters, which is an aphrodisiac. Who knew what he was doing? This guy was good. I was talking to my mother the other day, and she's mother now. Mom is long gone. She's mother, because she's over 50. She's starting to say weird things. You know, when you're like, we were young, and like, she embarrassed you. You were like, Mom, stop. No, I'm a size 8. No, stop. Billy's listening. No, fine. Stop. Now it's like, mother. Quiet down. That was racist. You're a bus. Make those comments to yourself. But I think, like, I'm the oldest of four, and I don't know if she's just like losing her mind or if she just doesn't care anymore. Like, my youngest brother's 12 and he was failing a class, and I was like, well, if I remember correctly, like, I was one of the last generations where you're allowed to beat your kid, but we called it a spanking.
Yeah.
Even if it was in the face. The last time my mom tried to hit me, I was like 16, 17, but basically a grown man. As close as I'm ever gonna get. I remember, like, I said something, she's like, I'm just sticking your mouth. And, like, went to slap me, and I just went, and just blocked it. And I looked over at my other brother, Charlie. Charlie went, you're ready. But she's starting to say weird things. I was talking to her on the phone, and she was like, hello, William. I was like, hi, Mom, how are you? She's like, I'm good. Will, she loves playing this game called Farmville, which is where you create your own farm on Facebook. And she called me, she's like, William, I noticed you didn't accept my horse on Farmville. What's going on? I'm like, Mom, I'm going to dinner with gay men for food. I got some shit I need to figure out. I know you're stressed. I just need to take some time out and smell the roses, because, you know, YOLO. She means you only live once, made famous by the rapper Drake. Based on that statement, I thought she liked him, so I bought her his album. And she snapped it in half and threw it at me and was like, this isn't real hip-hop. I've lost complete control of my entire life. I have this buddy, Rod, from college. His real name's Philip. We call him Rod for phallic purposes. But Rod, Rod's never... Yeah, it's a fun word. Rod's never really left the frat house. Like, we're out of school for a while now, and he calls me the other day. He's like, dude, bro. Bro's a Stalin, broski. I've known him for 6 years. I'm convinced he doesn't know my name. Will is fine. What's up, Rod? He's like, dude, last night, I slayed the illest chick. And I'm like, Rod, I hear that, and assume that you killed a baby chicken. And he's like, nah, dude, let me put you this way. Took her to the Bang Fest, gave her front row tickets. I was like, got that one, Rod. Coming in loud and clear. What's funny is, Rod's in med school now. And he's gonna be a pediatrician. Yeah, like, when I was 19, like, a pediatrician deals with anyone under 21. When I was 19, I had to get varicocele surgery, which is testicle surgery. Yeah, silence approved. Like, imagine Rod giving me that information. Like, he walks in, I'm sitting in my schmock with my mom and dad in the room. He comes in, he's like, Mom, Pops, Broski. Disclosure. Alright, so Slick Willie here, he's got an enlarged vein in his left testicle. We're gonna remove that thing, or he's gonna be shooting blanks in a couple years. Now, we got good news, we got bad news. The good news is, you're with me, so that's always good news. The bad news is, we're not gonna be able to give you any anesthesia. So you're gonna be awake this whole procedure. Yeah, now I'm like, hashtag ball surgery problems. And he's like, no, I'm just messing with you, bro. Let's pump you full of drugs and play with your private parts. Alright guys, it's been a lot of fun. I'm gonna let you go.